Good morning everybody, I'm going to show you how to connect your PandwaRF analysis tool to an Android phone using the USB host feature or USB OTG. So you need an Android smartphone with the USB host feature, a PandwaRF dongle and a USB OTG cable. So simply plug it to the smartphone, plug it into the PandwaRF and it's automatically recognized. So you can see many parameters are displayed, like the file descriptor, the vendor ID, the PID, the name of the device, etc. And it's automatically ready, no need to connect. You cannot connect to it because it's already connected. We are in USB. You can see that many BLE features are disabled because you don't have the BLE link, so you cannot get many information. But you can do the RXTX, Spectrum Analyzer, Broadforce, JavaScript, etc., Power, etc. So let's start with the Spectrum Analyzer, and you can notice that you have a new slider which is available, which is the number of channels. If you unplug it, you will see that it disappears, and you have a default number of channels for BLE, which is 52, but when you unplug the USB, you can fine-tune it. Let's start with the default value. You can see that it's much faster than BLE. Okay, let's press. Okay. Ah, I'm out. Okay, the range is not correct. So let's slide a little bit. I'm out of range. Oh. Putain. Okay. Okay, you can see. If I change the remote control, another one here. Okay. And I can also increase the frequency range. And you can see that the frequency range has increased. So, let's now force the RF amplifier always. An RX and redo again the spectrum analyzer. Okay, the power is much bigger. Okay, so let's go back to a number of channels more decent. That's 100. Okay, it's much faster and you have around 11 to 15, 20 measurements per second, which is quite high versus the BLE rate. Okay, of course, you can also do RXTX. Okay, let's keep the default value, sniff. Okay, data captured, not correct. Okay, data is much more interesting. A lot of zeros, but the correct data. Okay, so thanks for watching.